Hi, this is Camille, and welcome to the short YouTube tutorial for how to cite a website, a book, a YouTube video, and a picture in PowerPoint. Citing in PowerPoint isn't terribly different from other mediums that you may be working in. However, there are a few differences that I would like to point out. First, let's talk about how to cite a website in PowerPoint. Here are some of the common elements you may need to reference when citing a website. Website or author name, page name or article title, exact URL of website or page, date of publication. Here's an example of how it might look in APA and in MLA formatting. Now, the first thing you want to do is make sure that you have the full URL of the website that you are actually citing in your presentation to make sure you don't lose that exact URL. In this situation, I have the full URL here of the exact page that this content here is referring to. And you'll notice here, I actually have the name of the author of the website. So this could be anything from, NewYorkTimes.com or whatever it is. It's the name of, it would be the New York Times here. And then this is the title of the actual article that I'm citing that's on the web. And I've decided to not put the full URL here in the actual text body of the text because that would be a bit too much text to put all in one place. So I've just added a little superscript one here that is referring back to this text that's in the footer area so that it's clear that this is the exact source that I am citing from. Another way to do that would be to just even remove further information here and put more of it inside the source area down here below in the footer part of the slide. Another example here, we have a similar URL here. We have the full exact URL, and we also reference the author of the report that we're referencing. That's an online report that's here on by booking.com. Now, another and final way to cite websites in PowerPoint is to create a sources cited slide that you can have either at the very end of your presentation or at the end of a section that actually lists out the full details of the websites that you are referring to in the copy of your presentation. Now, if you want to learn more about how to create this exact superscript one here, this in-text citation versus non-in-text citation, or to create how to create a sources cited slide, check out this other YouTube video that I've created on how to cite properly in PowerPoint on screen now. Next, let's look at how to cite a book in PowerPoint. Here are some of the common elements you may need to reference when citing a book: author name, book title, publication date and location, and publisher name. Here's an example of how it might look in APA and in MLA formatting. Now, for books, you may or may not have some extra details that you need to make sure that you reference in your presentation for your citation. So, for example, in this situation, I have the author's name and the date here listed as an in-text citation that goes right after this quote. And I also have listed the author and the full name of the book along with the publisher here in the footer area of the slide. You may or may not need this much information depending on which type of citation you are actually, what citation style you're actually using. In this next example, I simply have this author's name and the date listed after the quote here, and that's enough. Again, you can decide if you want to have a sources cited page. This may be in addition or in replacement of some of these different styles. Again, you have to double check your citation style and make sure that you're following all those rules correctly. But this would be another way to add the citation of the sources that you are referring to in your presentation. Next, let's talk about how to cite a YouTube video in PowerPoint. Here are some of the common elements you may need to reference when citing a YouTube video: creator's name or screen name, video title, video URL, website name, and publication date. Here's an example of how it might look in APA and MLA formatting. In your presentation, if you are embedding a video from the web, from YouTube, from somebody else, you want to make sure that you include all the relevant information for someone to be able to go back and find the video that you were referencing and watch it, and to also make sure you're giving credit back to the author. Some things you want to include are the title of the video, the name of the author, and the date, along with the URL. In this example, I actually have a sources cited slide where I list out all the details of the video along with the URL where I retrieved this video. So in other words, the actual URL of the video on YouTube itself. And that is one way to make sure that you are referencing everything. This might not be enough depending on the citation style that you're using, or it may be enough because someone could look up this information on YouTube and find this video. So it's two kind of ways to do this, but you want to make sure that you are including as much information as possible and that you are following the citation style that you are being asked to follow. And finally, let's talk about how to cite a picture in PowerPoint. Here are the common elements you may need to reference when citing a picture: creator's name, title of the picture, date and location of publication, publisher or website, picture URL. Here's an example of how it might look in APA and MLA formatting. And citing a picture in PowerPoint is very similar to all the other types of content that you are citing in PowerPoint. However, you may also need to include a URL, especially if you have found that picture online. So in this example, I've taken a picture here from somebody on Flickr, and I've made sure that the image is copyright free, and so I'm allowed to use this picture properly. That is the number one mistake that people make. They find a picture online and they assume that it is usable in their presentation, and unfortunately it is often not the case. So you want to make sure that you are checking out the copyright rules for that particular image, or that you are purchasing the image and therefore getting a license to use it in your presentation. Now here I've put the photo credit to Kevin Bueller, and I've included the URL where I retrieved the image so that someone could go back in and find this picture. You can also do a similar example as I mentioned before, create a sources cited slide where you list out the full details, including the title of the photograph and where you found it online. I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to the channel with the notification bell activated so that you won't miss any future uploads. Also, don't forget to leave a comment down below with any PowerPoint questions you have, and we'll try to address them in the next video. Until next time, have a wonderful day.